As we can see, the relationship between the California kingsnake and the rattlesnake is a highly energetic one. When we look at the caloric demands of a California kingsnake, unfortunately, there's not a lot of available information on this. So we'll compare it to a similar family of snakes, the Mastacophis. The standard metabolic rate of this family is 0.08 milliliters of oxygen per gram per hour. And the exercise metabolic rate, or the field metabolic rate, is 0.956 milliliters of oxygen per gram per hour. This is the value we'll be using in our experiment. So using this value and doing the calculations, we can find that the average kingsnake would need approximately 41.87 kilocalories per year to survive. Now, based on their regular eating habits of eating about once a week, that would mean that they need 0.8052 kilocalories per week. That would be a meal of 805 calories per week. Now, the value of snake meat is about 93 calories per every 100 grams. The average body weight of a rattlesnake is 300 grams, which would mean that in every rattlesnake, there's approximately 280 calories, which would mean that it would take approximately 3 snakes a week to feed a kingsnake. When looking at the kingsnake versus rattlesnake populations, we can see that for rattlesnakes in the western region, there's approximately 100,000 of them. When dividing up this region into what would be for California, we can see that there would be 16,500 rattlesnakes approximately in California. We can also see that for kingsnakes, there's approximately 1 million in the North American region. Looking only for Californian kingsnakes, however, we can deduce that there would be about 50,000 kingsnakes in California. If there are 50,000 kingsnakes in California and 16,500 rattlesnakes, and if kingsnakes only ate rattlesnakes, the rattlesnake population in California would be eradicated in less than a week. However, this is not realistic. We're making a lot of assumptions in this exercise. For instance, our first assumption is that the kingsnake only eats rattlesnakes, which is not true, as the kingsnake has lots of other types of prey. The second is that rattlesnakes are not reproducing, which secondly is inaccurate. More realistically, let's assume that about 2% of kingsnake energy goes towards eating rattlesnakes. This would mean that in approximately 4 months, rattlesnake populations would be eradicated in California. Now let's say only 0.2% of kingsnake energy was going towards eating rattlesnakes. That would mean that in approximately 40 months, the rattlesnake population would be eradicated in California. Now, this is very unrealistic, but if there was only one kingsnake, that would mean that the rattlesnake population would be eradicated in 300 years if that one kingsnake only ate rattlesnakes.